Dear friends, this is my second lecture on the topic VSEPR theory. I have already given you some basic concept regarding the VSEPR theory in lecture 1. So if you wanted to get a real picture on this lecture 2 or VSEPR theory, I request you to go through the first lecture, then it will be very easy for you. So let me start from the lecture 2. In the board examination or university examination, sometimes you will be asked to write an essay on VSEPR theory. So you have to write these postulates for this examination. The postulate one is that this was proposed by a scientist whose name is Sedgwick and Powell, later modified by Nilom and Gillespie. This theory is used to explain the geometry or shape of the molecule. And third point, in a polyatomic molecules, around the central atom there is electron pairs. That electron pairs we call it as bond pair or lone pairs. This electron pairs repels each other, therefore they should be arranged in maximum angles, hence they will get maximum stability. The expected arrangement and shape is that if there are two electron pairs, the expected shape is linear and the normal bond angle is 180 degree, but in some cases it may deviate from these angles. Then three electron pairs, it is trigonal planar, the expected angle is 120 degree. Four electron pair tetrahedral, 109 degree, 28 minutes. 5 electron pair trigonal bipyramidal with the two angles, one is 120 angles, next one is 90 angle. And 6 electron pair, you will get octahedral shape, there is the angle is 90 degree. If there are 7 EP, the pentagonal bipyramidal is the shape and the expected angle is 90 degree and 72 degree. Then one more thing you have to keep in mind is that, consider a molecule H2O molecules, you can find that there is bond pair of electron is there, and lone pair of electron is there. This bond pair of electron is actually in between this oxygen atom and this hydrogen atom. Whereas in water molecules, this lone pair is on the oxygen atom. Therefore, these are very nearest, and definitely the repulsion between this lone pair and this lone pair will be highest. Whereas these are very far away, definitely this repulsion will be very low. Moreover, this bond is actually, it is contributed by this hydrogen atom and this oxygen atom, and therefore bond pair is contributed by this atom and this atom. The repulsion between bond pair and bond pair is less, whereas the repulsion between lone pair and lone pair will be much high because this lone pair is present on the atom. Definitely we can say that the order of repulsion is LP-LP repulsion is higher than LP-BP repulsion, which is higher than BP-BP repulsion. Then sixth point and last point is that multiple bond is taken as the single bond. For example, in the carbon dioxide molecules, you can say that C double bond O is there. This double bond is taken as single bond on noting or writing the structure or find outing the structure of the molecules. Now, these are the postulates of VSEPR theory. Then the next question you may be asked, that using VSEPR theory, explain the shape of the following molecules. The first example I am going to consider, that is beryllium chloride. Here there is central atom beryllium, atomic number is equal to 4, the configuration 2-2. Here there are two bonds, therefore 2BP. Here two electrons, these two electrons are forming bonds with the 2 chlorine atom. There will be no provision of lone pair, therefore 0 LP, therefore 2EP. Then you have to write here there are 2EP, 2BP, 0LP. In order to get minimum repulsion or maximum stability, they are arranged in linear with bond angle 180 degree. You have to write this structure also. Now BF3 molecules, similar in the case of BCl3, BBr3 and Ba3, all these have the similar geometry. Here the central atom is boron, atomic number is 5, configuration 2-3, outermost shell have 3 electrons. These three electrons are forming bonds with these three fluorine atoms. Therefore, there will be three bonds. Therefore, 3BP. There is no provision of lone pair, 0 lone pair, 3EP. Here there are 3EP, that is 3BP, 0LP. In order to get minimum repulsion and maximum stability, they are arranged in trigonal planar with the bond angle 120 degree. You know this structure. It is very simple structure. Now, CH4 molecules. CH4 Now CH4 molecule or CCl4 molecule or SiCl4 molecules, all these molecules have similar shape because they are present in the 14th group elements and all these have 4 electrons in the central atom. So here it is central atom carbon, 6 electrons, the configuration is 2-4, outermost shell have 4 bonds, that is 4BP0LP, that means 4EP, BP and LP is collectively known as EP, that is 4EP. Here there are 4EP. In order to get minimal repulsion, they are arranged in tetrahedral with bond angle 109 degree 28 minutes. Therefore you have to draw the structure of the molecule just like this way. For the beginners, it, I can draw the structure just like this way. One H here, yeah, and this lengthy H1 bond, this another one is lengthy bond, these two bonds are facing towards you, this is a short bond, this represent, this bond is away from the observer, and this all these angles is equal to 109 degree 28 minutes. Keep in mind that this is a three-dimensional molecules. Now PCl5 molecules or PF5 molecules, generally PX5 molecules, central atom P 15 285, 5 bonds, 5 BP, 0 LP, 5 EP. There are 5 EP. In order to get minimal repulsion, they are arranged in trigonal bipyramidal with the bond angle 120 degree and 90 degree. This is the way of drawing the trigonal bipyramidal shape. This is the trigon and one bond is here and next bond is here. When you connect this one, you will get a pyramidal shape. This pyramid have the base of a trigon. That is why it is called a trigonal pyramidal. If you are drawing one more pyramid just like this way, you will get another pyramid. That is why it is called a trigonal bipyramidal. Here, this trigonal, these bonds are in the plane, and this one is perpendicular to this plane. Definitely these bonds we call it as axial bonds. This is again axial bond, this is equatorial bond, equatorial bond, equatorial bond. Here the angle between this axial bond and equatorial bond, it is because they are mutually perpendicular, it is equal to 90 degree, but here it is equal to 120 degree, this equal to 120 degree, and this equal to 120 degree, whereas the angle between an axial bond and equatorial bond is 90 degree. Therefore in this axial bond there are 2 electrons there, here also 2 electrons here, definitely there will be a repulsion of angle of 90 degree. But here the repulsion between this bond and this bond is by an angle of 120 degree. Definitely this angle is less, definitely this will experiences more repulsion than these bonds. That is why I can say that axial bond, in this axial bond experiences more repulsion. Therefore these two bonds, two electrons move something away from this phosphorus atom, definitely this bond length will increases. That means here there are two types of PCl bond, two axial PCl bond and three equatorial PCl bond. Axial bond experiences more repulsion than equatorial bond, hence axial bond length is higher than equatorial bond length. Therefore PCl5 molecule is unsymmetric and they undergo decomposition to give PCl3 and Cl2. That means this bond and this bond, there is a possibility of removal of this atom and this atom, that is why you will get PCl3 and Cl2. Next molecule is SF6 molecule. Atomic number sulfur, atomic number of sulfur is equal to 16. 286, 6 bond, 6BP, 0LP, 6EP. Here there are 6EP, 6BP, 0LP. In order to get minimal repulsion, they are arranged in octahedral with the bond angle equal to 90 degree. This is octahedral. This is also known as square bipyramidal because this is a square. When you connected this bond, you will get a pyramidal shape, have a base of a square. Similarly, if you connected this side also, you will get another pyramid, have a base of square. That is why it's called a square bipyramidal, also known as octahedral, because it have 8 faces. That is why it is called octahedral. Now I have 7, central atom I. You don't have to know the atomic number of iodine, but you know it is a 17th group elements. The configuration is 2...7. Here there are 7 bonds, 7BP, 0LP, 7LP. Here there are 7EP. Therefore, in order to get minimal repulsion, they are arranged in pentagonal bipyramidal with bond angle 90 degree and 72 degree. This is taken as a pentagon. This is in a plane and this one are mutually perpendicular. The angle between this one and this one, you take it as 90 degree because they are perpendicular. Angle between this bond is taken as 72 degree. That is why the total involved 360 divided by 5, 72. That is why it called 72 degree. It have the bond angle. The already discussed molecule does not have lone pairs. Now I am going to discuss the molecule which have both bond pair and lone pairs. For example, SNCl2 molecule, PbCl2 molecule, SiCl2 molecules, all these three molecules have a similar shape because all this belongs to the same group, that is 14 group elements. Therefore, the configuration you can write that is 2 dot 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 4. Here there are two bonds, out 4 electrons in the outermost shell, only 2 electrons is taken per in bond, therefore 2 BP, therefore 2 electron is rest is this, that is taken as 1 lone pair, that is 3 EP. Here there are 3 EP, 2 BP, 1 LP. Therefore, the expected shape is trigonal planar, but due to the presence of one lone pair, the actual shape is V shape or angular shape. Since, you know, since LPBP repulsion is higher than BPBP, the bond angle is less than 120 degrees. That means we are expecting a trigonal planar shape, but one is a lone pair. On drawing the actual shape of the molecule, you can neglect this lone pairs. Therefore, this you will get the shape. This is known as V shape. Next one is NH3, NCl3, PF3, PSCl3, SBH3. All these atoms belong to the same group. Therefore, I can say that all these atoms have 5 electrons in the outermost shell. Then central atom here is nitrogen, 7, 2, 5. 3 bonds is there. 3 bonds. The rest is 2 electrons. That is taken as 1 lone pair. Total 4 EP. Therefore, there are 4 EP. 3 BP and 1 LP, therefore the expected shape is tetrahedral, but due to the presence of one lone pair, the actual shape is pyramidal shape, You know, here is a pyramidal shape, here the lone pair, we are expecting a tetrahedral shape, but here only one is a lone pair, therefore this is the shape of a ammonia molecules. Since LPBP repulsion is there and LPBP repulsion is there, due to this, this bond angle is less than 109 degree, that is 107 degree. Now H2O molecules, central atom O, 8, 2 bonds, 2 BP, 2 LP, 4 AP. Here there are 4 AP, 2 BP and 2 LP, you know, you can say the outermost 6 electrons. Out of this, 2 electrons used for bonding, there is 4 electron is thrust, 4 electron is 2 pair, that is why 2 LP. In order to get minimum repulsion, they are arranged in tetrahedral. Therefore, the expected shape is tetrahedral. But due to the presence of two lone pair, the actual shape is V or bent or angular shape. Then you can say that here there is lone pair is there, lone pair is there. Since lone pair repulsion is higher than this repulsion, these bonds comes close together. Due to this, this angle is equal to 104 degree 5 minute. Now, if you consider big molecules, you can find that one point keep in mind, that is if there is a trigonal bipyramidal shaped molecules and there is a lone pair is also there, you keep in mind that this lone pair should occupies at equatorial position, because the most safe position of lone pairs in this trigonal bipyramidal shape is at equatorial positions. Whereas if there are 6 electron pairs, I mean octahedral shape we are expecting, there you can put this lone pairs in the axial position. And if there are 7 EP also, you can say it in the axial position, because in these cases axial position is best, in this cases equatorial position is best. Now look at the molecules, SFR, sulfur, 16 286, there are 4 bond is there, therefore 4 BP you can say, the rest is 2 electrons, that is 1 lone pair, total 4 plus 1, that is 5 EP. The expected shape is trigonal bipyramidal, but there is a lone pair, it should go to equatorial. That is, you are expecting a trigonal bipyramidal shape just like this one, but there is a one lone pair that should keep here. So we are, if you are drawing the structure, you don't have to mind about lone pair, the shape is seesaw shape. Now CLF3 molecules, here again 287, 3 bonds, therefore 3 BP, the rest is 4 electrons, that is 2 LP, total 5 EP. The expected shape is trigonal bipyramidal, but there is 2 lone pair, it should go to the equatorial positions. Therefore, the shape is just like this way. This is, you can take it as a T shape. When you put a, on the, when you invert this molecule, you will get a T shape. Now, XCF2. The atomic number of X you don't have to know. It belongs to 18th group elements. Definitely, it have 8 electrons in the outermost shell. The expected configuration, you can say that 2 dot 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 8. Here there are 2 bonds, therefore 2 BP, the rest is 6 electrons, that is 3 LP, 5EP, the expected shape is diagonal by period, but there is three lone pairs. These three lone pairs should be at equatorial position. The rest of the molecule have a linear shape. Now ClF5 molecules, here chlorine 17, the atomic number 17, 287, 5 bonds, 5BP, 1LP, 6EP, the expected shape is octahedral, but one lone pair is there. That lone pair should be in axial position in octahedral shape, equatorial position in trigonal bipyramidal shape. Therefore, the shape is square pyramidal. Now, XeF4 molecules, 4 bonds, 4BP, 2LP, 6EP, the accepted shape is octahedral, but due to the presence of two lone pairs, the shape is a square planar shape. XeF6, 2.8, 6BP, 1LP, 7EP, the expected shape is pentagonal bipyramidal, but due to the presence of one lone pair that will goes to the axial position, the shape is square pyramidal or distorted octahedron. This is all about the VSEPR theory. So somebody wants to, if you want the handwritten notes on this VSEPR theory, you can contact me through this WhatsApp number 9387849592. Thank you.